I suppose my biggest inspiration now is probably is my dad. He's just an incredible guy. Like, he's non-stop, you know, been through a lot in his life. He's had 2 heart attacks, and yeah, he just keeps going. When I was being brought up, I was surrounded by, you know, home-cooked meals. There was nothing absolutely fantastic. They were just nice home-cooked meals, which, you know, I think is a sort of a good step in the right direction from the get-go. Throughout my career, I've worked at sort of various different establishments, ending up at Hipping Hall. I've been here for the past 5 years now, been head chef for 4 of those. I fell in love with it from day one, and then, yeah, when I was asked to become head chef, it was, yeah, a no-brainer for me. So our menus is basically what we can get our hands on. We'll take a lot of really great proteins, whether it be sort of meat or fish. At the moment, it's a sort of 11 courses, again, just sort of highlighting what's best, what's in season, what we can pick. And yeah, we just sort of put it onto a plate quite simply, really. It's all sort of native British ingredients that we've sort of got from the 3 counties we're surrounded by. I think our location here sort of sets us apart from other sort of little restaurants. We're sort of based right on a little pocket of Lancashire, which borders onto Yorkshire and Cumbria as well. So, you know, you can throw a stone into all 3 counties from where Hipping Hall is situated. So, yeah, it gives us a fantastic chance to tap into incredible produce. The first dish I'm making today is going to be a beef pastrami dish. So yeah, it might not sound that English, but we've used a lot of English sort of spices on there, the stuff that we picked throughout the years. It's a short rib of Dexter, which is brined for about 10 days, and it's slowly cooked for 2 days. Cook it in a water bath, 65 degrees. And then what we do is we glaze it with a malt glaze. We finish it with a few sort of local spices. And then we barbecue it just to give it a real nice sort of smokiness. And then on that dish is going to be almond cream, which is infused with bone marrow. And then smoked cucumbers, some little fresh fennel shoots. And it's just finished off with a licorice oil. So yeah, to begin with beef, we just lightly trim it up. We leave a little layer of fat on there just because fat's brilliant. And then we brine that. So it goes into a brine made with a little bit of pink salt, thyme, garlic in there. Then it's just a 5% brine, which we leave it wet brine in for about 10 days. And then it's washed off, it goes into the same recipe of brine, and again vat packs, and then that goes into a water bath, and we leave that for 2 days in the water bath at 65 degrees. Then comes out of the water bath, we glaze it up with a malt glaze, we brush it up with that, and then it's covered in a light coating of the spices, and then that's just finished on a barbecue just to give it a real sort of nice sort of smoky background flavour, basically. Again, we sort of let it cool down, and then we vat pack it again just to let all the flavours seal straight back into it, and then we just slice that up afterwards. We'll buy in the ribs of beef, and then we can use that in sort of several different ways. So we'll take the main eye for just the main cut on the actual dish. Yeah, a couple of pieces which are sort of braisable on there. And then there's the rib cap again, which I find is probably one of the sort of most underrated and best cuts, I think, on beef, basically, to use as a steak. Flavour is just absolutely phenomenal from it, and it's just so tender. And then, yeah, we use the sort of short rib as well, which, you know, we'll use in a few different forms. So, yeah, for this one, obviously, like I said, I've sort of turned it into a pastrami. Spices that we used on this one is seeds which were collected from mustard plants. It's a plant had overgrown, collected all the seeds from those, dried them out, so it's got a little sort of pepperiness to it. And then hogweed, again, that's got that sort of orange, cardamom-y sort of flavour, which gives it a really sort of interesting background. It all comes down to using the right thing. You know, there's no point in picking up a recipe from somewhere and just going, oh, you know, I'll just recreate that. Like, it has to be those ingredients which we picked, we foraged, or, you know, this beef which we're sourcing. I think there's a lot of steps that sort of come to recreating a dish like this.